ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wickes, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded big money match, Game 76. And now here's the star of match Game 76.
Welcome back. Nice to have you with us. And a brisk round of applause for the new kid on the block, Mary Wick of Doc. We have a tradition on the show.
It's a snappy outfit.
Thank you.
It's all right.
Every time we get a new kid on the block.
Oh, I hope so.
Female gender. Have to give her a proper welcome. No fun.
Excuse us.
No funny stuff now.
Why not?
We're a little late, folks.
Cut away.
And no makeup on you either.
No makeup on me. Terrific. Thank you very much, my dear.
Proper welcome. Good for the rest of the day.
Now, Marjorie Hart and Laurie Smith are ready. Ladies, how much money do you want us to get?
$5,600.
Now, you've had a little time to think about what you can do with that amount, have you? What?
A lot of things.
Oh, all right. She doesn't want to say. Well, that's all right.
I don't want to be held to one thing.
Okay.
My mind changes.
You are allowed to change your mind. And you're going to be challenged now by Laurie Smith. We found out a little bit about her. Let's just review briefly where you're from and all that, Laurie.
Oh, I'm from Laverne, California.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm married and have 4 kids.
Okay. Good luck to both ladies. We'll begin in a moment, but right now, this for you. Now, we're going to start from the top. Da capo, as they say in the music world. Here we go. Laurie, it's your choice, A or B?
A.
A? Ready? Jack's dog, Fido, is so big.
How big is it?
Let me tell you how big it is. This dog is so big, it trained Jack. Every night, Fido makes Jack blank. He's got a big dog, you see. So big that it trained Jack instead of Jack training the dog, you see. So every night, Fido makes Jack blank.
Makes Jack blank.
Blank, right.
You see, with this hairdo, I ruin the whole effect if I wear my glasses.
Oh.
What's your name? Is Mr.
Smart
Ray?
It's the washerwoman's curls there. Oh, that's
all me.
Very. That's all you.
Yes, and Elena did it because she's
right.
Smart and clever.
Jimmy LaForte does mine.
Jimmy LaForte.
He's better than Elena.
Wait a minute now, sweetheart. Now we turn it forward, then we snap it in there like that.
Would you leave him alone and do
he
your thing?
He just asked me. I was trying to help
I
him
see.
Out, poor little
devil. Ask me. It's my show. Don't bother.
Let me ask you.
What?
You sprayed your mouth before you kissed her.
Yes.
What does your breath normally smell like?
Take a chance and be offensive. You know, she is a guest in my house, and I just didn't want to take
just
any chances. Hello, Laurie.
Hi.
Jack's dog, Fido, is so big, it trained Jack. Every night, Fido makes Jack blank.
Roll over.
I don't like that too much, but that's one of the tricks you teach a dog to do, isn't it? Roll over? What do you say,
Joey? I was thinking in those terms also. It makes him heal.
Heel.
Oh.
Heel is another thing a treat she does. All right. What do you say?
Well, I have a dog, and just before I left home today, I stepped in a large puddle on the kitchen floor. So I said he made him go on the paper.
Fido makes Jack go on the paper?
Uh-huh. Isn't it cute?
Yes, darling. Charles?
You sure it was the dog?
No.
Go on the paper. All right. Now, Mary, this is your first time.
I know. Listen, with her hair like that, doesn't Brett look like she has money?
Yes, she does.
I'm taking her out of my will. Just obviously not.
Show and tell time.
Do you want to know what it is?
Yes.
All
every
right.
night, Fido makes Jack
go outdoors, which I think is very good and kind of like the puddle up
yes,
there.
Yes, right. Go outdoors.
You get the feeling that it's the same sort of thing.
Yes, I got the idea there. Okay.
I'm Richard. Very enthusiastic.
Now, I'm just a traffic cop here, man.
That's true.
I don't have to be enthusiastic.
And don't you ever forget it.
I'm in love with her.
Yes. Now, Richard, we're up to you. Jack's dog, Fido, is so big it trained Jack. Every night, Fido makes Jack
sit up and beg.
Sit up and beg. Yeah. That's a cute thing.
That is sweet.
Teaches him to do. What did you say?
Well, going along with the puddles,
yeah.
I said it makes him take a walk.
See?
Take a walk, yeah.
Yeah, that's outdoors.
That would be the thing.
That's right.
All right, so there, Laurie, none for you, and now we'll see how Marjorie does with her first rounder. The first round ones are a little tough, you know. Albert said this. He said, I am never going back to that health food restaurant. When I found a bug in my food, the waiter said, don't worry, it's blank. He said, I am never going back to that health food restaurant. When I found a bug in my food, the waiter said, don't worry, it's blank.
I love him, the nerve of him shielding his answer from me.
Shh.
There are two wonderful choices I can't make up.
Remember, it's a health food restaurant.
I know it. I know that's the operative phrase.
That was good, wasn't it?
That's very good. Nice to have you back again.
Oh,
we haven't seen you in a long time.
Where's your spray?
Not true. Not true.
No.
I was for health food before it was chic.
While we're waiting, would you like to take my pulse, nurse?
Where were you before you came here?
All right. Here we go, Marjorie. Oh. Albert said, I'm never going back to that health food restaurant. When I found a bug in my food, the waiter said, don't worry, it's...
organic.
Organic is... Yeah. Cute answer, huh, Joey?
See, my right answer would have taken too long. When he found a little bug in there, the waiter said, don't worry, how much can a little bug eat? See, but
right.
I know that she's got to think differently. I said, it's healthy for you.
It's healthy for you.
Like,
right.
By that kind of money I'm getting, I don't need that, folks.
Sit down. What do you say?
I told you there were two terrific answers,
right? One was?
Marjorie, hang in with me. Organically grown.
Organically grown. There you go. Do you have the other terrific answer, Charles?
I like the first one, organic.
Organic, that's good.
Oh, organic.
What is the other terrific answer?
Maybe
she has it. Mary, have you got it?
Well, I'll tell you, it depends on how you look at your health food. Roughage.
It's roughage.
I see.
Need a little bit of that.
Well, it's the first time I was wrong since the World's Fair. First time I was wrong since the World's Fair.
All right.
I think you're going to be asked to be a regular here. We
That's
like
right.
That.
Yeah. Now.
And they'll be asking me to leave. You're a funny lady.
Yes.
I said organic.
Organic. That's another one. Marjorie, you're up to three. When I found a bug in my food, the waiter said, don't worry, it's organic. What do you say?
I started to say it was a vegetarian bug, but I didn't. I said it was organic.
You thought of it. That's four for you, none for you at the end of round one. Now we'll see how round two progresses in a moment or so, but first this for you. Freddie, round two coming up. Here we go. Laurie, A or B?
A.
A reads as follows. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Gordon the Grease Monkey is so greasy every night he slides off his blank. That's how greasy he is.
Gordon the Grease Monkey is so greasy.
Just a good one.
He slides off.
Every night he slides off his blank.
Okay. I think I got it.
Every night he slides off his...
Oh, mercy, I hope
of course.
My
wonderful.
Oh, Richard.
Wonderful.
Richard.
All right. Here we go. Laurie Smith. Gordon the Grease Monkey is so greasy every night he slides off his...
Bed.
I think you got about a third of the audience with you there. Let's see what we have up here.
Every time I write something clean, they say something dirty. So this time I wrote he slides off his behind.
Slides off his... Okay.
Oh, it's better than a boo.
What do you have him sliding off of?
I think I've gotten a little closer to the grain.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is the definitive answer. I said he slid off his wife.
Right.
You know, I think I can play this game better without my glasses.
Yes, you do indeed. Charles, she's got to match you right now to stay in the game. What do you say? She's looking for bed.
I have to match her?
Well, she has to match you.
She has to match me?
Right.
Okay.
All right. Score is 4-1. You match all the others, we'll have a tie. What do you say, Mary?
Well, I'll tell you, there's so many things he could slide off of, you know, depending on how he goes home. Bus, subway,
right.
Almost anything. But I picture him getting home, getting settled, and sliding off his bed.
Oh! 4-2.
Oh, I got a place over here.
All right.
If you don't sit on it.
No, I don't. You can put mine.
No, it's okay.
Go ahead, sir. I'm sorry.
He's tall. They're hard to find.
All right, Richard, she's looking for a bed.
I said wife.
Wife! So, Marjorie wins again. What's your hat? I didn't know how long you were going to sit up there. Okay, you hang around here, Marjorie, while we say hello to goodbye to Laurie Smith. Hello, Laurie Smith,
hello.
And goodbye, Laurie Smith. We've got gifts for you together with our thanks.
Oh, thank you.
Nice to have you with us. Goodbye,
dear. Bye-bye.
Okay. Here it is again. Second time up here, Marjorie. Shall we have a go at it?
Yeah, I'd love to.
All right, we polled a recent studio audience, Marjorie. We got their best response to this. Joey Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match that middle one, you get $250. The third one gets you $100. Now, you may select three of the six celebrities for a little assist.
I'll take Brett.
What about Joey Bishop? He'll kill me if I don't say that.
Okay.
Richard.
Joey Lewis.
Joey Lewis.
Charles.
Joey Faye.
What?
Joey Faye is a comedian, and he
and
was
a
marvelous,
burlesque.
A famous burlesque comedian. He was married to Barbara Stanwyck, as I remember.
That was Frank Faye.
That was Frank Faye. Frank Faye was married to Barbara Stanwyck.
Joey
Faye was his brother-in-law by a previous marriage there.
He does funny sneezes, Joey Faye. One of those bits.
Now, Marjorie, you got Bishop, Joey Bishop, Joey Faye, and Joey Lewis. Now, you can choose one of those, or you might have had a better idea. What do you say?
No, I don't have a better idea. I love Joey Bishop.
Okay.
Oh. He'll be there somewhere.
That was the answer that Brett gave. Let's find out if Joey Bishop is up there. And we're going to find out if he's going to be low man on the totem pole or high man on the totem pole. How much esteem did that bunch have for him? Is he under the $100 number? No.
Joey
they misunderstood.
Brown.
That was Joey Brown. I guess that audience misunderstood, didn't they? We're looking for Joey Bishop. Let's find out if he's a $250 act. Joey Heatherton.
Oh.
He was married to Barbara Stanwyck.
Joey Heatherton was married to Barbara Stanwyck?
Yeah.
Right.
They were seeing the Faye brothers.
All right. Last chance for Joey Bishop. Slide it, Earl.
I do not understand this show at all.
Why don't you understand this show?
She said she loves me and ran to her.
Yeah. I gave her the answer.
I'll tell you why. She kisses better than you do. That's why.
Oh, he's a pretty good little kisser, though.
That's right. Oh. You're up to $6,200.
I love it.
Yeah, the fact that you won the $500 means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. But you've got to match one celebrity to collect.
Brett.
Oh, 2 weeks in a row, I don't know.
It's easy, Brett.
Sure.
Just concentrate and get your ESP going. Thought waves. I want to see thought waves going between you and Brett. All right, Marjorie, here it is. It's worth $5,000. Blank writer. W-R-I-T-E-R. Blank writer.
I'm sorry. Do it again, would you?
Writer. W-R-I-T-E-R.
Writer.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Wait a minute. Just a minute.
Blank
don't
writer?
Anybody.
Blank
don't panic. Don't rush me. Don't. Wait a minute. There are so many.
Oh, I'm going to go with that. No, I think that's...
Okay, she's made up her mind, Marjorie. Now we ask you to make up your mind.
Ghost Rider.
Ooh, Ghost Rider.
Do I dare, Wolf?
Yes, let's turn around. Brett, she says Ghost Rider will match
you. You know, I'm sorry. I thought it was an inside joke. I put typewriter. I'm sorry.
Typewriter.
Ghost Rider.
Typewriter is good. Ghost Rider is good. They're both good. I guess there are a number of others there,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I thought Ghost Rider is another special.
One. Skywriter. Okay. Now, Marjorie, you got your 6,200. You'll need another player later, but right now we want to do a little business with America, okay?
Terrific.
Shall we present a new player? Let's welcome Mr. Larry Guthrie. You have a friend out there, Larry?
Two. Or maybe three.
Really? Where are you from, Larry?
Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm.
Lived here all my life.
What do you do?
Well, I work for an organization that does large-scale systems work. And,
large-scale systems?
Systems work, yes.
Whatever that means.
Engineering.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Doesn't he have beautiful hair?
Thank you.
Looks like who?
It took a while.
He looks a little bit like Alan Ludden, yeah.
Really?
Why don't you call Betty White?
Yeah.
That would be nice.
It would indeed be
yes,
nice.
Indeed.
Fall off the chair. Be like Alan Ludden. Do something like that. All right. Larry, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank
and
you.
Who, you got your family out here, friends?
My daughter, my son, and my daughter's friend.
Okay. Good luck to you. Let's begin, shall we? You may have A or B, Larry.
I'd like A.
All right. You can have A. It's all right with us. Louise had her face lifted so many times, if you look under her hat, you can see her blank.
Mercy! Oh, my word.
Coming from the medical world, you would know about that, wouldn't you?
Louise had her face lifted so many times, you look under her hat.
If you look under her hat, you can see her blank. I said, take my blank.
There.
Take back your blank. Yeah. Your blanks will never be. What's going on there?
Nothing's going on. The lady's molested me.
I got it.
If you look under her hat, you can see her blank. All right, we'll walk over here to Larry Guthrie and see if he's ready. Ready, Larry?
Yes.
Go. Louise had her face lifted so many times, if you look under her hat, you can see her blank.
Scars.
Now, do you know how they do facelifts?
Yeah.
How?
They make an incision, and they...
Then they pull up the
pull
skin,
up the
right?
Skin,
right.
Sew it back together.
Okay, now, wait. In a moment, you'll see what I'm trying to get to here, Larry. Joey, show him your answer.
Well, yeah. She had so many...
She has had her face lifted so many times. If you look under her hat, you can see her...
Boobs.
Her boobs.
I don't need that, folks.
Yes, you do. What do you say?
Johnny, that's not an unusual answer. You know, they just start pulling, and the first thing you know, you see those little bosoms right under your hat.
That's it, right there. Well, what they do, don't they make an incision right here and pull the skin up there?
Well, you
so
ought to know, Gene.
Oh, wait a minute. What do you say, Charles?
He's kidding.
No, Brett had so many face liftings that every time she smiles, she pulls up her stockings.
That old turkey.
Chin. All right, what do you say, Mary?
Well, being a nurse and all,
yes,
I know how these things are done.
Chilling down. What were you trying to do, take my temperature
no,
down
no,
there?
No, not at all.
No.
Whenever she smiles, there was such a facelift, one of those bits,
yeah,
that you see her mercy. I'm having trouble with the props. Navel!
Navel! You got the idea. She's
yeah
in there. You got the idea? Navel, yes, indeed. You got the idea now, Larry?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
you get in the swing late in the second round.
What about Bertha Mae Belmont?
Bertha Mae what?
Belmont.
Bertha Mae Belmont. What do you say?
Well, I didn't say anything about the Navy. I said her belly button.
Belly button. Same thing.
It's rather sweet.
Okay. And we'll do one for you in a moment or so, but first we want to do this for you.
Yeah, have a bowl shot.
Right. Here we go. No, we're not going anywhere. We got to quit right now. Will you come back next time?
Sure.
Love to.
Okay. Bring your father, Alan Ludden, too, would you, Larry?
I'll try.
Right.
I'll see if he's in.
Yes, okay. Listen.
He does look like Alan Ludden, that's for sure.
He does indeed.
I think Alan's moonlighting. Myself.
Well, he is currently between engagements. Well, what night of the week is your show on?
On Doc. Saturdays at 8:30 on CBS.
CBS, Doc.
Same thing next season, same time, I mean.
Right.
Right.
Now, do you wear the same thing all the time, the cute little thing on your head and the white starched...
Every now and then I get into rather suggestive low-cut things. No, every once in a while I get into civvies, as it were.
Yeah.
It's a fun show to do.
Good. How about this one, now that you've done your first one?
Oh, I love it.
Good.
I love it.
Good.
What a nice audience.
Well, you can come back tomorrow.
Oh, thank you.
Team Raymond here. Thanks, guys.